The career of a young man. So if he wants to make a point whether Kevin Lyon is going to do it, he's going to get across the team in the start. We saw that earlier this season, the two players across the team. Over the years, Kevin has been so successful because he's clearly straight out of his belief and straight out of his it doesn't surprise me that there's a difference in our history. Thank you. In the years past, he tried to tell us that they would work. This is what he really believed. And that's what he said. Really have the advantage of the front court. This play, Temple has been a much bigger front court than the Central Hawks. This year, the Hawks are very good at front court. That's the reason I think it's one of those things for the club. It's just for the game. The front court is a good one. That's what I'm going to put there as well for his ability to get to the basket. Temple's fearless. Temple Christmas when he goes to the basket. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Now, the tough approach is to say, they credit this most when they play with the Here in the Atlantic Center, even the NBA, how about Samir Nelson? Only a freshman. Now you understand why he has been the rookie of the week four times in the Atlantic Conference. They've been very good on the offensive glass because they always keep their two feet at the right post. Seven line again in the right spot at the right time. And even though Sam's not with the rounder, because they have a body on Kevin Love, he's got a rebound. But right now, this is a big calmness to the Steve basketball club. It's the same poise that Phil Martelli would say a balance, the balance between intensity and confidence.
I don't know. over a textbook, I'm going to go to the next slide.
Going to be good enough to win tonight. we saw the last thing about it, but if you want to make this thing to go down to the left, over the years has done a good job of keeping the ball out of the lane. You're going to beat the second team that's to do it, and it's going to experience that fantasy struggle right to the top of the Temple defense. It's going to be a little that is not what John is reading. Please forgive us if the rest of the field is there. Right now, Woody Greer is starting to assert himself more out of his work. He's taken off of the ball, he's not bringing the ball up the court. Riley is now finishing the ball up the court, passes to Greer, and Greer is going to start to take his air balls out of the ball and try to get to the center. In order to bail his team out of a difficult situation. That time, St. Joe's scattered the inbounds play. They knew the ball was coming into the clear. They did not clear the ball, and Temple was forced to take the timeout. So, historically, John wants his team to read the situation and use one of his timeouts in order to attack St. Joe's defense. Taken away. if you're afraid to have a success,
when we return to this.
Basketball Anakin here. This is Clara Center during the last game and host for the playground. Robin O'Connor was unhappy with the call. He didn't think it was a wrong. Glenn Greer walked up there and tried to take the ball out of his hand. Just don't do that. You don't do it on the playground. You do not do it here in the Atlantic Center. So that's exciting. Very excitable for Robin O'Connor. And you can see a little pushing and shoving at Charlie. You just did a good job of getting that out of the way. I'm going to go to the next Well, this is again where it's so difficult for Temple to come back. So Kevin Lai that time correctly read the defense, which took the ball back up the offense, and the offense was feeling it. Pressure as possible on the St. Joe Hawks. And again, here, it's been rare and Riley. Riley's feeling it is spots up. Again, it all keyed off of Temple defense. And that's what John Chase is going to try to get more of as we get into the last 8 minutes of this game. Turn up the defensive pressure, get the ball to the left, try to get some easier basket. But you can see the pressure on the tire. Now these players are playing a lot of minutes. Clint Greer's minutes is over 39 minutes a game. And the reason that Temple can get away with that is comfortable because they have to go to the team. Now they're going to step it up by foot court defense. What is the game going to do?
Clint Greer, more than a 673, but also 680
Well, Temple played has done a good job of putting more of the but Temple has not taken advantage of it. And the opportunity was taken away, especially when Tamir Dustin, at the other end of the court, drives to the basket and comes up with a key basket to keep this lead. All the college players in Philadelphia get a chance to play together in the summer, see why they're in college. So, what's the difference between Marvin O'Connor and Brent Miller, or in this case, Tamir Dustin, and Brent Miller? It's going to be a great experience. It's all about the success of the first year. It's going to be a great year in Philadelphia, and for the first time, this time you have basketball league. Thank you.
Thank you.
When you get a sense here, and it's like it's about the tempo has turned up its defense. They changed from the talent to man to man, but they've actually created some opportunities in transition with that time. Crenshaw almost forced the foul Hawkins before he had an easy basket. The tempo defense has been better in the second half, and the great thing about Jack Sweeney is he'll find a way to teach his players to his experience. Still get better as Smith continues to have a great stretch here of six in a row. So now that there's not much of a bounce to the ball, the picture is 12 consecutive eighth grade quarter of the game.
To the free throw line. Jordan Hawkins is freshman 64 from the floor, 3 or 5 in the free throw line, 17 points. 4 rebounds, 3 steals.
But you just gotta be impressed with the way he's carried himself tonight. Not only scoring, but how about rebounding the basketball? He's done a very good job on the defensive end. He's been the most effective player for the Temple Owls tonight.
Four double figures for this 12.
is 6.12.